This conference will now be recorded.
If you want to filter multiple values, we have seen filtering Nagaraju or one location values. So if I want to filter out scene Connery from this data frame, if you recall the day before yesterday's class, I'm writing bond actor is equal to scene Connery, and I'm storing it in a variable, and I'm writing bond of mask off so that true false will convert into the values. So when I run this, see, all the scene Connery movies have come up for me. Agreed with line 64? So if I want to change this guy's name to Pawan now, I want to change the movie's name, hero's name to Pawan. Okay, so bond dot of loc of mask is this filter, actor name I'm changing to Pawan. So when I run this, now see, Pawan is hero for all these movies.
Okay,
so if you want to modify the column values, this particular loc and ix will give you advantage.
Okay.
Filtering, I suggest you do by this method, direct method, which we know. But when you are modifying, you can write like this dot loc of or ix of, and your filter comma actor is equal to so and so hero name. Okay, understood or any question?
No.
Oh, wonderful. So now I want to know which movies this guy is acting, Roger Moore. These both give me the same answer. Either this method, both are same. It's up to you how you want to write. Line 47, both the methods are same. Is it okay?
Yeah.
Okay. So let's see. Renaming the column name. So suppose here you see the columns are year, actor, director, box office, budget, bond actor, salary. Okay, six columns unnai mandigra. These six columns ki, suppose I want to change the year name to release date and box office name to revenue. So how you have to write bond dot of rename of columns is equal to, you have to write it in dictionary format. Year is year came, you change it to release date. Box office came, you change it to revenue. And in place true is for modifying the data frame. So when you run this and check your bond data frame, you see year has changed to release date and box office has changed to revenue. Any questions on this?
No.
Nagaraju?
No.
Okay, wonderful. Ante dictionary key betesukoni match chesukovali. Ade suppose bond, ippudu column names em em unnai find out chesukovali anukunte, bond dot of columns, it will give you the column names. Okay? Directly, if you want to modify every column name, you can write bond of column names is equal to, you can define all the column names. Okay, if you are having six columns, you have to write six column names exactly. So it will go index wise. Release date will change to year of release, actor will change to actor, director will change to director, revenue will change to gross, budget will change to cost, bond actor salary will change to salary. But if you suppose by mistake you don't define one particular column name, then it will tell you I was expecting six but you gave me five. So you have to be careful when you are directly replacing like this. Now if you check the bond dot head, it has changed. So if you want to change only one column name, you should write it in dictionary format. If you want to change every column name, you can change it like this blindly. Mm-hmm. Okay, now?
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, how in get the time on the Rojki?
Inka
Panimsha on nine code to them. Okay, data frame I'm running. Index column is equal to film. Suppose I want to drop a view to kill movie. Okay, bond dot of drop of view to kill. When I run this, now you see this movie is gone. I am dropping this row view to kill.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Suppose you want to pop out an actor from the bond data frame. So you have to write bond dot of pop off you. This column I want to pop out. Actor column I don't want. So when you run this and store it into variable, this, if you see, index along with the actor name is pulled out. So this would come practically into help when you are having an order column, suppose Nagaraju, and you are having number of orders placed for that. So suppose your index column is your order and the next column is your order count. So you can write that order dot of pop of order count column and then store it into one variable, and it will have only these two columns, which will help you out if you want to store it into one data frame or a series. Is it okay?
Right.
Okay, so directly, this is more easier way of deleting something. Delete of bond of director. See, director is gone. More easy, no? Okay, any questions on delete or pop or remove? Okay. Okay, we will play some game now. Okay, I want to know what is the difference between head and sample, tail and sample. Head, tail, sample. I want to know. It's very easy, very self-explanatory also. What will happen when we use head? What will happen when we use tail? What will happen when we use sample?
So head is top 10 records, tail is bottom 10 records, sample is random 10 records.
That's it. Self-explanatory, man. So out of the data frame, if you want to see just a sample of records, you can write sample. So head will give you the first 10 records. You can see here view to kill to Goldfinger. As a sample of 10 and Rasse, it will give you random sample. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Next, n largest and smallest. Okay. So this data frame, for this data frame, you are sorting basing on the box office column in descending order. So whichever is getting the highest revenue. Okay. On that, if I want to figure out three most top movies basing on the box office collections, like Bahubali, Allu Arjun, what was that movie name? Allah Vaikunthapuram, and then Mahesh Babu. So this one, box office collection, three topmost movies from this data frame: Skyfall, Thunderball, Goldfinger. Okay. If you wanted five topmost movies on the box office collections, you can write like this. So n largest will help you out getting the number of records basing on the column that you want. If you want only one movie which is the topmost collection, then it is Skyfall.
So this n largest and n smallest works only on float, right?
Yes, obviously.
Yeah.
Float or in int?
Yeah.
Number column.
Okay.
But n largest, n smallest will work better. Okay, it will work anyways. If you don't do sort also, it will work. Okay. This sort is only for your reference. Okay, let's just comment it out. In smallest, if you want to see the least movies, like the flop ones among the bond, which has generated less of revenue. Two movies that I want to see the least revenue were, okay, at that point in time might be these people, this generated lesser revenue: License to Kill and A View to Kill. Okay.
Yep.
if you want to see basing on the budget, which was the three highest spent to movies. Simple. Okay, if you want to see basing on the salary of the actor, this keep first, keep last does not make any sense, but actually I'll tell you why I've written this. In largest to take three variables. One is the number of the variables that you, one number of the values that you want to see, based on which column you want to see, and keep first or keep last. So here I'm keeping key first and running. So what is happening? I got these three records. Suppose I run the same with key last. The result turns out to be same. So this keep variable does not make much of a sense when you are using n largest and n smallest.
So when does
you
it
can see the
when does it make it
I don't know, man. I don't know. You can research more on that in Pandas, that web page.
Okay.
See, answer wise, if you run this, I don't see a difference. What is the difference between these two? Same code, I changed one variable.
If it changes, if you put a very large set, like if you take like 10,000 or a million or something.
Good question, but without this n is equal to 3, it won't work. That is a mandatory variable.
Okay,
it won't work. So this is mandatory. So I also checked it out, but it wasn't making much of a sense for me.
Okay. Yeah,
then suppose you want to know largest, I mean the most highest collected movies basing on the box office, n largest of 8, it will give you in descending order, and then n smallest basing on which was the oldest movie among the Bonds. Okay,
so Bond anedi manam ichama name lekapothe adi by default
చూద్దాం.